Now let's see what we have here. Pumpkin, yes, very good. And tomatoes, yes. I'll be right with you folks, I'm just finishing up my inventory here. Let's see here, and oh no. Oh, not Mrs. Cleveland, not today with all this work. She'll be in here talking and buying nothing.
Mr. Jones, so good to see you again. It's been so long, at least several months, wouldn't you say?
Well, it seems like yesterday.
Oh, well, I can use your telephone. Seems you have the only one within miles.
Well, I will place the call for you.
Yes. Oh, do you remember on our last visit, Dr. Cleveland and I were accompanied by our dear friends, Mr. and Mrs. Fred Birch? The Fred Birches of Pontiac, I introduced them to you.
Yes, you did.
Such nice people. But they couldn't possibly make it this trip.
Oh.
Too much to do. Social engagements. So I'm here alone until my husband comes this weekend.
Yes, ma'am. The telephone's right over
Must
here.
Must keep myself busy. Have I told you about my new pastime?
It was fancy work.
No,
yes.
That was last year.
Oh.
My new avocation is photography.
Oh.
Nothing better than to saunter through the green fields, invigorated by the country air, and with an artist's eye, capture the panorama of a local color.
Oh, well, that you must be in luck. I just so happen to have a very nice photographic album for those pictures of yours right here.
Oh, not the kind of quality I'm looking for.
Oh, but Mrs. Cleveland, this is our finest.
No, I'm sorry, Mr. Jones. Although this is an interesting item, I'm sure I can find a much better one in Detroit.
Oh.
Have I told you about the number of department stores we have and such a variety of goods?
Yes, many times you've told me, yes.
City living exposes you to so many wonderful things. So much variety. Not to say that your little enterprise isn't well stocked for the needs of the locals. But I require more.
More?
More.
Yes?
Which reminds me, the telephone!
Oh.
I have to telephone my husband.
Yes, well, it's still over here. What number should I ask for?
Number 172.
172. Very good. Coming up.
What we would do without a telephone. It makes communication so much easier.
Yes, please connect me to Detroit, number 172. Yes, and notify me of the charges when the call is
complete. Cleveland, Mr. Jones.
Yes, ma'am. Central? Yeah, Cleveland? No, that's the name of the party. Yeah. Ah, here you are, ringing.
Thank you.
Mm-hmm.
Hello, dear. How are you? Listen, I'm going to need you to buy some things and bring them with you. Because I can't seem to find what I'm looking for here in this moment. Get something right with so you won't forget.
Her nose is so high in the air, she could drown in a rainstorm.
What? Did you say it's going to rain?
No, it's not going to
rain. It's going to rain, dear. I'll need my umbrella.
Oh, Mrs. Cleveland, I have umbrellas.
No. And I need soap.
Oh, soap?
No, the kind we buy at J.L. Hudson's. The soap at the Exchange Hotel is far too dry for my delicate skin. Edward, are you still listening? So he'll arrive on the 6:40 train Friday. No, I haven't been wishing yet. Don't forget those things. Ah, oh, Mr. Jones, you are so fortunate that the pressures of the day do not weigh as heavily on your shoulders as they do on Dr. Cleveland, who is consumed by the health of the world.
Oh.
He has so little time to enjoy the simple, quiet life of you country folk.
Well, Mrs. Cleveland, I'll have you know that it's not always simple and quiet for us country folk. If you'll pardon me for just one moment, please.
Yes.
Central. Yep, 37 cents.
Oh,
yes, thank you very much.
Put it on my account.
Yes, ma'am. So, did I hear that you and Dr. Cleveland will be doing a little fishing this weekend?
Yes, a particular sport I'm quite adept at, if I must say so.
Uh-huh.
The Birches mentioned an article about the fishing harvest was mentioned in the Pontiac Bill poster.
Oh, my.
Did you happen to see it?
No, I must have missed that one. I do regret that. However, Mrs. Cleveland, you will not find finer fishing equipment anywhere around, not even in your city of Detroit.
Ooh. You must tell me where I can find more exciting fishing spots to sharpen my skill.
The mill pond is so picturesque, but it doesn't present the challenge I'm looking for.
Oh.
I've practically caught all the fish there are.
Have you?
I'm looking for bigger game, as they say.
Ah, bigger game, I understand. Well, let's see, there's Loon Lake out here in Drayton Plains. That's it's a lovely spot for fishing. But, well, we also have Maystay Lake out this way. Oh, and then we also have Elizabeth Lake. People can go picnicking out that way, too.
Oh, how delightful!
Mm-hmm.
Dr. Cleveland and I can go fishing and have a picnic.
Yes, ma'am, but about these fishing rods.
Hooks!
Oh, hooks?
Yes, exactly.
Yes, well, how many?
I'll need six. Oh, I think one will do.
One fishing hook.
Yes.
Right.
I thought Dr. Cleveland and I could go fishing and convince Mrs. Rat at the exchange to cook our catch.
Mm-hmm.
I'm sure whatever we catch will be more nourishing and far more tasty than what they serve at the exchange. I can't seem to eat any of their food.
Oh.
It's far too heavy for my taste, and it upsets my stomach. That reminds me. Pepsi,
oh, well, I'm happy to say that the J.R. Jones store stocks not one, but two such medicines. I'm certain one of them will suit you. Yes, now this one is made by the Shakers, who believe in the curative power of herbs. This Shaker cordial is guaranteed to cure consumptive people or those with sick headaches or anything that might be wrong with you. They recommend you take a few drops after every meal. However, yes, now this is Hostetter's Bitters. It's a fine medicine which people tell me works like wonders.
Contains 25% alcohol.
Yes, ma'am. Works wonders on anything that ails you.
I'll take the Shakers.
Uh-huh.
Seems to me one can cure one's stomach without damaging one's head in the process.
I see. Yes. Well, that will be $1 for the larger size.
I'll take the small.
25 cents.
Just put that on my account, too.
Yes, ma'am. Is there anything else I can do for you? We certainly try to accommodate our city visitors by making sure they can easily acquire those conveniences so necessary for a successful weekend in this primitive little hamlet of ours. May I interest you in a few pickles to take along on that picnic?
Tell me, do you get that many city visitors come your way?
Hmm?
Mr. Bratt at the exchange tells me he plans on opening a summer resort.
Oh, yes, ma'am. In fact, many city visitors seem to find Waterford really quite agreeable.
Oh, dear. I hope not.
I was hoping to keep this peaceful little hamlet all to myself.
Oh.
It would be a shame to have it overrun by the same people one wishes to avoid in the city.
Yes, it would. Anything else?
No. I think that'll do.
All right.
Oh, you have sweets! And cream drops.
Yes, ma'am. Even in the country, we like our little delicacies.
How much are they?
They are 50 cents a box, ma'am.
All right.
All right.
You do have such a sweet tooth. I'll take one.
One box it is.
No. One piece.
Oh, all right. Let's go ahead and pick a winner there. Here you go. No, but, they're very... I don't know how it got that way. I'm sorry. You don't have to have that one. They're... I assure you that any one would suffice.
Best one. Oh, here it is.
Oh, there you are.
Delicious.
Oh, good.
Well, just put all of those things on my account.
Yes.
When Dr. Cleveland arrives, he'll pay for my things. I don't bother to carry money around with me.
Oh.
Well, I think I bought enough for one day.
My goodness, Elsa.
Your little establishment is so entertaining.
Oh, well, thank you for that compliment. Thank you.
Oh. Oh, lovely.
Oh, that's a beautiful cake basket, isn't it? You know, my fancy goods have been selling very well with my local customers. They must make city folk like you feel right at home.
Mr. Jones, this is so upsetting.
What?
Selling exquisite silver-plated tableware? Yes. Attracting more and more people from the city?
Yes.
If you and Mr. Rat continue, you'll ruin dear quaint little Waterford for me.
Good day.
I know. Mm-hmm.
Let's see what she bought, folks. Let's make sure we have this recorded properly here. Let's see, there was one fishing hook, and one bottle of digestive medicine, small, one telephone call, and one piece of candy. Total comes to 68 cents, most of which goes to the telephone company. Well, maybe Mrs. Cleveland has a point. I'm not so sure I want folks from the city coming out to Waterford now either. Well, if they all spend like her, I'll be out of business in a week.